Alrighty then, I have some update news for you. My name is Fersonus and welcome to Ark Survival Evolved. As you can see, Ark state of the game 15 minutes ago. So we have some fresh news for you. Update news. So let's go check it out. Well, about all this update news, the first thing they want to say is that they finally completed the game for the console disc retail submission. So that is nice that they made that. And will the official servers be wiping? Short answer, no. So no, the official servers will not be wiped when the game is getting released. So keep that in mind, it is not getting wiped. But they added something else. When the game is getting released, all the old servers are getting called legacy servers. And they're gonna launch new PvP servers, a new cluster. And that new cluster is separated from the old cluster. And here you can see it, an additional new PvP server cluster network is coming alongside but separated from the PvP legacy cluster. So the PvP legacy cluster are all the current PvP servers that are in the game now. And with this new PvP cluster, you can go to that map and that map is completely new, empty. No old stuff, no players with tech tier and all that kind of stuff. And you cannot do any cross-arc stuff between the old servers, the legacy servers, and this new PvP cluster network. Well, that is good news for the people that wanted to have a wipe, and also good news for people that didn't want to have a wipe. So if you wanted to have a wipe, then you can now go to those new PvP servers and yeah, you can go check them out after the game is released and you have a fresh new start. And there is also something happening to the old legacy servers. 10% of the lowest count servers across all platforms, so also console, will get a new purpose. And this means that those servers get wiped, because they are called ghost town servers. Only a few people are playing on it, and yeah, that is not enough. The costs are way too high for that. Well, they're gonna preserve all the save files. They will upload them, so you can download them and you can use them. But this means that, yeah, for the people that play multiplayer on it, well, then you have to use them for your own server, or you can play them in single player. And something else about the legacy servers, another concern has been raised. Legacy servers will still be getting supported in regards to the future DLC, Ragnarok and all the future maps and all the game stuff. And for the PvE people, well, I don't have any news about if there is coming a new PvE cluster with new servers, totally fresh, apart from all the old servers. So no news about that today, maybe in the future, but for now I don't know that. And then it is time for the Ragnarok news. For console, it is coming to console, the Ragnarok map, but you have to wait 3 more weeks. Damn, 3 more weeks of waiting. Yes, I know it is sad news for a lot of you, but you have to wait until the game is getting released. And why is that? Well, first of all, then they have time to develop the map further, so you get a better released version of it than it is now on PC. Also, they can use all the workforce now to work on stability, quest exploits, duplicating, DDoS and all the kind of stuff. So it will be much smoother experience when a map is available. And also, remember what I said about the legacy, that the old server is becoming a legacy server? Well, it would be a little bit weird that a couple of weeks old server of Ragnarok, if they're gonna release it now, would become a legacy when Ark is getting released. So yeah, a total fresh new start on the 8th of August for Ragnarok on console. And then we have PlayStation 4 update news. Well, the update is coming this Friday. Well, at least they say it is coming this Friday. And it will be a late evening patch, probably. So maybe it is even getting to be Saturday morning. I don't know. But at least, the update is coming. Well, and then I have some news about the console PC hosted service. Yes, it is coming. It is coming. You can host a server on PC after the game is launched at the 8th of August. You can host a server on PC for the console, so for Xbox and for PlayStation 4. And this is nice because now you don't need a second console anymore to host a private server. So that is nice. And also, you have complete access to all the configuration options for the .ini files. And you can tweak it even more than you can do now on the console. That is nice. They also come with an option to cross-arc server cluster stuff. So you can travel between all the maps. And of course you can create backup files, and that is nice because if you tweak something and you screw it up, then you can put your backup on and then it is all fine. Better performance because of better optimization. And those server slots, well, they come up to 100 server slots. That is nice. And later they also gonna implement Play Anywhere. And I don't know what they mean with Play Anywhere. Does it mean that you can play on PC and with console players and with PC players, that you can host a server like that? I don't know what they mean with that. If you know that, leave that in the comment below, because I don't know. And then some latest news about the development kit. Well, it is getting updated soon, and later today it will be available. At least that is what they say, and after that it will of course be also coming to the Unreal Launcher. And they are confident in its stability, and after this you will be able to get the latest information on the forums regarding to any relevant and cool changes. So I guess the dev kit is after this not going to be much updated anymore. It will be the latest version, and hopefully it will bring something good for you and you can completely work with your mods and make some awesome stuff, because we all love the mods. Yes, we do. And that is all the news that I can tell you about the game, and yeah, of course we want to have more news, but this is all they have shared with us, and yeah, I'm wondering how it is going for PvE and some other things, but yeah, this is only the news we have. So hopefully I brought some good news for you, even if you have to wait a little bit longer on for Ragnarok and all the kind of stuff, but hopefully there is some good news in this video for you. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, leave any thoughts about this video or whatever in the comment below, and as always, if you haven't already and you want to see more of me in the future, then smash that subscribe button like a maniac, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye bye.